Whoa, I have to stop. I have to stop. Oh my gosh. Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm Hannah, I'm a voice teacher, and today I'm reacting to Ariana Grande singing The Wizard and I. So my last musical theater reaction for Ariana was Still Hurting, and you can watch that video to see, I wasn't such a big fan of it. I thought that it needed a little bit more clarity and a little bit more of that musical theater style. It was totally her signature style, and I was just not a fan in that particular song. But I got a lot of comments saying that she killed this song. So I'm really excited to hear it and see what I think. So let's jump into it. I like her makeup. That's a great mix. So that's a C5. This song is really hard, guys. I've broken it down a couple times on my TikTok. It's incredibly hard. It spends a lot of time in that kind of danger zone, that no man's land of our first passage. And our passages, also referred to as bridges or breaks, are transition points in our voice where we're moving from one register to the next. And our first passage is between our chest voice and our head voice. And that's where they come together and we have to start doing some mixing. So that's on a C5. She's mixing through that really well. And it's not heavy or shouty. There's not too much chest voice in that. It's really balanced. I like that a lot. Ooh, that's a great chest voice. Oh, I love the audience. Wow, she's doing a really good job. I'm very impressed. I have to say that I don't advocate for belting like this with your head to the side and your mouth wide open. That usually gives us like a squeeze to your voice and constricts your voice a little bit, but she sounds really good while she's doing it. So if it works for her. Also, who looks good in green lipstick? She looks fantastic. No father is not proud of you. No sister acts. I love this mix right here. That's great. And this gift or this curse I have inside. Maybe let's don't know why. Ooh, that why? Maybe let's don't know why. Beautiful open vowel vibrato. Ooh. That's a pretty head voice. Not important to me. All right, why not? I'll reply. What a pair will be. I kind of like the little riffs that she's throwing in there. They're not too flashy or overpowering or like she's trying to turn it into a pop style, but they feel very authentic to her, and I like that a lot. Yes, what a pair. There she is. There's Ariana. That sounds just like her normal songs. She's giving a little bit more breath on the bottom than I would prefer. Unlimited. it is a little bit breathy down there. It is really low. That bottom note is actually an F sharp. Ooh, that is low. So it is totally possible that Ariana as a soprano doesn't have as much chest voice on that note. I certainly don't, but I would love to take out a little bit of that breath. So it's not on, it's unlimited. There's a little bit more strength, a little bit more of her speaking voice quality in those chest voice notes.
My future is unlimited, and I just had a vision almost like a prophecy. I know it sounds
funny. I love that. That was fun.
True, the vision's hazy, but I swear someday there'll be a celebration throughout us. That's all.
She's adding a lot more flair.
With me.
Love that. I have to stop. Oh my gosh. Okay, the first thing that she's doing in that moment that is so great is she's keeping me a pure E vowel. She's not trying to change that to may or meh. It's very open and resonant, but it has that E vowel, and she's actually incorporating some of her head voice on that note. It has more of a mix there. Really nice. It's not straining or being too heavy. And then she opens it up on "and I'll stand there," and it's not, again, very wide, "and I'll stand there." It's more like an "eh," "and I'll stand there," and that's really great. She has a lot of control through that. I love that she starts smiling like she knows that she's getting it right. That's really fun.
With me.
Really balanced. I love that high note. That's great. Oh my gosh, Elphaba. Wait a second. Oh my gosh. I kind of like that. Probably not on a Broadway stage, but that's kind of cool. And again, she keeps it an E vowel. That's very, very important. I love it.
The wizard. Hello.
That I has a little bit of an into it. Wow, that was really nice. And I also have to say that there's something that's like really magical to me of this entire audience singing along with a musical theater song. I love that. My inner theater kid is just like so excited that so many people love Wicked, and Wicked was the bridge for a lot of people into musical theater. Same with Hamilton. Like, that's how people got into loving musical theater, and I think that's really cool. I've always been an Ariana fan. I think that she's really amazing. In my last video, I had a lot to say because I just wanted her to give me a little bit more of that musical theater style, and she did here. And I think it was also very fun that she added her own flair. Those riffs at the end were really nice. And what I was missing from when she was singing Still Hurting was more resistance. There was a lot of air coming through her voice, which is something that she adds into her songs a lot. And I loved in this song, these big belts had a lot of resistance. So her vocal cords were resisting the air really strongly instead of letting any of it kind of sneak out. Oh, that was really great. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any other suggestions of people I should be reacting to, please let me know in the comments. And until next time, I'm Hannah. I'm your voice teacher. And now you're all my students. Please like and subscribe. Ring the bell for notifications. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok. And I'll see you next time. Oh, gosh. I'm so excited.